Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install PyCharm IDE in a Windows 11 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install PyCharm IDE, you need to just simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar, you need to just simply type PyCharm download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.jetbrains.com is basically your first search result. So just now simply click on download PyCharm, and this is now going to redirect you to this official site of PyCharm. In here you'll be getting this option called Windows, macOS and Linux. So we are basically going to download it for Windows, so we just want to simply keep on this Windows tab, and here you'll be getting professional one and community one. Now we want to use this PyCharm community one since it is absolutely free. So what we are going to do is we are going to just simply click on this download button, and this will now going to start downloading our PyCharm. Since I have already downloaded it, I just need to simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see that latest version of PyCharm community 2021.2.3 has been rightly downloaded over here. Now to install, you need to just simply double click on it, and this will now going to ask you for administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes, and you'll be seeing welcome to PyCharm community edition setup. So this is basically the installation wizard. So just simply minimize our download directory, and here just simply click on next, and you can clearly see that this is going to be our destination folder. So just simply keep this as a default. Also check this, that you need to have 1 GB of free space in your C drive, so do check that also, and then just simply click on next. Now under installation option, you need to check some options. So first it is asking whether you'd like to create a desktop shortcut, so I'd like to check this so that I can create a desktop shortcut over here, right? And then I'd also like to check this open folder as a project, so that I can open any folder that is related to Python, I can open directly as a project, right? And I would also like to check this .py so that all Python related files can be opened with PyCharm. And this is very important, you need to also check this bin folder to path, right? So that you can automatically set our environment variables right at the installation. And then after checking all this, just simply click on next. And now it's telling that it will going to create this JetBrains folder. So just simply keep this as default, and then just simply click on install. And it will going to start installing our PyCharm community edition setup. So this entire process will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after installing our PyCharm. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now as you can clearly see, it's currently telling that completing PyCharm community edition setup, and it's asking whether you'd like to reboot it now or you want to manually reboot later. So for which I'd like to reboot it now, and it is also very recommended. So just simply check that and then just simply click on finish, and again come back to basically start our PyCharm community edition. Yeah. So after rebooting your system, you'll be landed over here once again, and here you'll find that you'll be getting this PyCharm community edition desktop shortcut has been actually installed. So just simply open that to basically launch our PyCharm community edition setup, and you can see it is currently asking whether you'd like to import PyCharm settings. So if you have previously installed PyCharm, then you need to just simply going to click on this configure installation directory, and then you need to simply browse it. But I don't want that right now, so I'll just simply click on this do not import settings, and then just simply click on OK. And this will going to launch our PyCharm community edition 2021.2. So welcome to PyCharm. Just maximize it, and this is going to be our interface of our PyCharm. So in here I am also going to show you how to write a simple hello world program and how to run them. So for that, you need to just simply click on this new project, and this is going to open this new window. In here you need to give your project name, right? So let's give a project name as a hello world, let's say, right? And this you can keep this as a default. So this is where they're going to be create this folder, and here only your project is going to be located. So keep this as a default, and we are going to use Python 3.9, right? So if you haven't installed Python 3.9, then also it is totally fine. It will going to download it, right? So keep these other things as a default and then just, you know, simply click on create. And this is, you know, going to start downloading our Python, since as I have told you that if you haven't installed Python earlier, then it's not a problem. So currently showing the tip of the day, so you just, you know, simply check this don't show tips, then just, you know, simply click on close, right? So that this does not come again and again, and you can clearly see it is currently downloading 3.9.5 Python. So this will take, you know, a couple of minutes, I would say. So again, I'll be coming back after installing our Python 3.9. yeah. And now, as you can see, that our Python has been actually installed and our program is also launched. So this is our Hello World program also launched. So just simply maximize it, and you can see that they have already created this printi method. And here from our main, we are calling our printi, right, by passing this variable PyCharm, which is getting received over here, and it is going to print hi PyCharm, right? So if you just simply keep this as a default, and if you just simply click on this run button, it will, you know, going to show hi PyCharm over here. So let's say you change this PyCharm to hello world, and then if you just simply click on this run button, can see hello world has been rightly shown over here, right? So in this way, you can easily install PyCharm in a Windows 11 operating system. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and so please do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.